Well, I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in today. It is, I come at this with some mixed feelings. I suppose it's obviously a good day when we see the political parties agreeing that the United States should not default on its debt obligations tomorrow. And I'm hopeful that the compromise that was reached will actually pass both the House and Senate today. But I think it's important that we recognize and understand that what we will accomplish over the next 36 hours is a fix in terms of an August 2nd deadline, but it is not the full long-term solution that the country needs to get our debt to GDP ratio back in line. I still think the more comprehensive bipartisan approach that we had suggested with the over a third of the Senate has at least a framework of going forward, because while this plan does cut over $2 trillion in spending, we do need to see deficit reduction that gets closer to $4 trillion over the next 10 years to really make our balance sheets and, most importantly, give the American consumers and American business community the confidence they need to start reinvesting and creating jobs in our country. And that means that the two big, I guess, elephant and donkey in the room that still needs to be addressed are: how do we do entitlement reform that ensures that the promise of Social Security, the promise of Medicare will be there for decades to come? How do we do tax reform in a way that makes our tax code fairer, but also generates the kind of revenues we need to not expand government, but frankly, to make sure that we pay the bills on the promises of Social Security and Medicare? And those issues still have to be wrestled in the coming months. And what I hope to do is keep this one bipartisan coalition in this town alive, continuing to advocate that if, as we revisit this issue in the fall, that we'll be continuing to advocate for a comprehensive solution. But before I get to questions, I do say it is with a sigh of relief, and I know enormous amount of frustrations from Virginians who have been scratching their heads saying, why in the heck couldn't this get done earlier? But the fact is, a deal has been made, and I'm hopeful that it'll pass both the House and the Senate so it can get signed by the President, and we can remove this cloud from everybody's daily life that has been hanging over for at least the last few weeks.